everyone, welcome back to our new tutorial. Hope you guys are well. So today in this tutorial I am going to show you how we can create this amazing beautiful cursor animation using HTML, CSS and a little bit of JavaScript. And if you can see that our cursor is actually changing its color after a few amounts of time, and it's changing its color continuously to a different color. And we have added some functionalities to this cursor animation. First one is actually whenever I will stop moving our cursor, it will hide into our screen. So now I will stop the moving of our cursor. Here you can see that whenever we stopped moving our cursor, our animation is not now showing, it's actually in our hiding position. And now whenever I will start moving our cursor, here you can see that we can see our cursor animation. And another functionality is whenever I will go out of our screen, it will stop the animation. Here you can see that whenever I will go out of our screen, our animation will stop. So these are the functionalities, and in a few moments I will show you how we can create this animation using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. And before we start, if you guys are new in my channel, then please subscribe, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, you guys can comment below. So let's get started. In our code editor, first you have to create a HTML boilerplate, then you have to add a style sheet also. Here you can see that I am giving a title and then I am linking my style sheet, which is style.css. Now let's go to our body, and here first we have to create a div tag, and then now let's create a class for this div tag, and the class name will be cursor. That's it. And underneath this div tag we have to create a section. Let's create a class for this section, and the class name for this section will be main. That's it. And then I will create a heading, this cursor animation heading. So that's why create a h1, and this will be cursor animation. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Here you can see that we have our heading here. Now let's go to our style sheet, type our body, and here first I will give a height, and the height will be 100 VH. Then I will create a background color, and our background color will be this one. Then we have to initialize cursor, and it will be none. So after this one, now we have to target our main class. So copy this class from here and then paste it here. So first we have to give a height, and the height will be 100 VH. Then we have to give justify content center, then align items center. And here at the first it will be actually display flags. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Here you can see that we have our background color, and then our heading is actually in the center position, and we can't see any cursor here. Here you can see that we can't see any cursor. Then we have to target our main again. Then we have to now target our h1. So first I will give a color of our heading. So our color of this heading, it will be this one. Then I have to give a font size, and the font size will be 65 pixels. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Here you can see that now we have our cursor animation heading here. And if we now go to our real website, here you can see that we have actually two circles here. We have a bigger circle, and inside this bigger circle we have a small circle. Now we have to create these two circles in our this website here also. So for doing this, go to our HTML, and from here copy this cursor and then paste it here. That's it. So first I will give a Z index, and it will be 999. Then I will give a position, and the position will be fixed. Then I have to give a background color of our cursor, and our background color of this cursor will be this one. Then we have to give a width, and the width will be 20 pixel, and the height will be also 20 pixel. Then we have to give a border radius, and the border radius will be 50%, because I want a rounded border like a circle. Then we have to add our pointer events, and it will be none. That's it. And now I will add some box shadow, and the box shadow will be 0, 0 and then 20 pixel, and our color will be this one. So I will just simply copy this one and then paste it two more time. That's it. And this one will be 60, and this one will be 100. That's it. Then I will add transform, and the transform translate, it will be -50%, then -50%. And now I will add our animation here, because I want to change the color after a few amounts of time. So that's why we have to add animation, and the name of our animation will be colors. and the time will be 5 seconds and it will be infinity. That's it. And for a starting point, it will be display none. That's it. Now we have to add our animation colors here. So that's why first we have to call our keyframes and then our animation name. So this will be colors. So our first one will be 0%. So in our 0%, it will be actually filter, because I will add filter for changing our color. So that's why filter, and it will be hue rotate. So first one will be 0 degree, and then I will copy this one and paste it here. And our second one will be 100%, and this one will be 360 degree. So now after this one, now we have to create our bigger circle. Our bigger circle, here you can see that we have created our smaller circle. Now we have to create our bigger circle. So for creating this one, copy this class name from here and then paste it here. So now we have to target our pseudo element, which is before. That's it. Now our content will be empty. Then our position will be absolute. Now I will give a width, and the width will be 50 pixel, and our height will be also 50 pixel. And then now I will add a border radius, and the border radius will be 50%, because I want a rounded border like a circle. Then I have to give a background color, and our background color will be this one. Then I have to give a opacity, and our opacity will be 0.2, because I don't want to give same opacity for our bigger and for our smaller, and I want this one to take opacity 0.2. then I had to add our transform and translate, and it will be -30%, then -30%. That's it. So after this one, now we have to go to our index.html file, and here we have to add some script, JavaScript. So that's why here create a script file, and inside this script, first we have to target our cursor, this cursor. So for targeting someone, first we have to create a variable for this one, honest, and then our variable name will be cursor. That's it. So now we have to target our this class, cursor class. So that's why here we have to first write document.querySelector. So here we have to type our class name. So our class name is cursor. That's it. Then we have to add another variable, and this will be var, and this variable name will be timeout. That's it. So we have to create a function here, and we have to create this function for follow our mouse movement, because whenever I will move our mouse, our cursor animation will actually follow that movement. So that's why first I will comment out, and this will be cursor movement. That's it. So let's create the function. So this will be document.addEventListener. That's it. And this will be for our mouse movement. And now here we have to add our x position and y position. So that's why let x, and it will be e dot our page x. That's it. Then we have to let our y also, and it will be also e dot page y. And then we have to style our cursor, and it will be dot style dot top. And for our top, it will be y plus pixel. That's it. So let's copy this line from here and then paste here. And this one will be for our left, and this will be x, and this one will be for our display, and it will be block. That's it. So after this one, now we have to create another function for stopping our cursor animation whenever we will stop our movement of our pointer. So that's why, so first comment out, and it will be stop animation, and this one will be function, and our function name will be mouse stopped, and it will be empty. Then for our body part, we have to copy this one and then paste it here. So whenever we stop moving our cursor, I want to stop our animation also. So that's why cursor style, and this will be none. So after this one, now we have to create another argument, and this argument is for actually hiding our animation, because if we don't move our cursor for a few seconds, I will hide our cursor. So that's why it will be hide animation. So for this one, we have to clear, and here it will be timeout. That's it. Then we have to add a new timeout. So that's why, and our handler will be mouse stopped. That's it. Now we have to give a time here. Now I will give 1000 milliseconds. And here if we stop our cursor moving for this amount of time, we will hide our animation. So that's why we have to create this argument. That's it. Now save, go to our website, and now refresh. So here you can see that now we can see our cursor animation here. And then now if we go out of our screen, here you can see that our cursor animation is not hiding, we have to stop our animation whenever I will go out of our screen. So that's why we have to create another function. So for creating this one, first I will comment out and it will be a stop animation of the screen. That's it. So for here also we have to call our document. Then we have to add event listener. And here it will be mouse out. That's it. And we have to delete these lines. And then here we have to give an empty parameter. That's it. Copy this line from here. Then paste it here. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. Now if we go out of our screen, here you can see that. Here you can see that our animation is successfully stopped whenever I will go out of our screen. And this is actually looking good, I think. And here you can see that our cursor animation is actually changing its color after a few amounts of time. And if we now stop our cursor for 1 second, and here we can see our cursor animation. And if we now start our moving, here you can see that we can see again our cursor animation. And this cursor animation is looking also beautiful. So that's it guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and if you guys really enjoyed this tutorial, then please subscribe, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, you guys can comment below. So let's see you guys in our next tutorial.